Hello everyone and welcome to the Tech Sera. Today we are going to look at the Galaxy Z Flip bending screen, or as we like to call it, the foldable screen. At the unveiling of the Galaxy Z Flip, Samsung was categorical that it was glass. Its ultra-thin glass sounded like a breakthrough when the foldable phone was announced. It was said to break the laws of physics.
Every time you fold it, you're not just bending glass, you're bending the laws of physics.
Yeah. A folding glass, but it's not a glass display the way you would think it is. A YouTube tech blogger, Zach Nelson, got his hands on the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip and did a test review on the phone which did not inspire confidence. His YouTube page is Jerry Rick Everything. Durability test shows that the Z Flip's display starts to show permanent marks and scratches far earlier than actual glass would. However, Samsung flexible ultra-thin glass is made by a company called Scott. The screen is actual glass, it actually bends and can actually break, just like a regular glass does, if you abuse it or get unlucky. It's really glass except that it's really thin and without protection it's going to break very easily. So Samsung thought it wise to add a protective plastic layer on the top of the glass. The Samsung flexible screen, or better so, the foldable screen, is made up of four layers. First, you need some sort of backing so nothing could come in contact with a circuit board inside the phone. You wouldn't like the screen to go short out and go zap. And on top of this layer, which is the backing, you have the actual display, the part that shows everything you see on the screen. And there is also a digitizer, that's a fancy word for touchscreen. And it's the part that registers precisely where you touch and for how long. And then on top of this digitizer, you have it's a piece of glass. Not just any glass will work, as you need something that thin and designed not to scratch easily. And also electrically conductive, enough so that the digitizer can register where you are touching. Whilst this may seem a little simple, but when it comes to when you expect the display to fold in half, everything gets more complex and many of the parts need to be designed in-house. Now, the screen will be made up of a flexible OLED panel that can twist and fold and bend like the LG flexible OLED panel. And the digitizer likewise is a film sheet and folding, so there's no much of a problem either here. Now, the top layer is supposed to be made up of a normal Gorilla Corning Gorilla Glass on a regular phone. But when it is a fold, when it's supposed to fold, it is going to be a whole lot of problem, or it's going to be so much complex. Samsung had to come up with a solution, and with the original Galaxy Fold, that solution was a plastic display. Since the words plastic display have such a negative stigma when it comes to touchscreen devices like a phone, with a Galaxy Flip, Samsung worked further and used a glass display, technically anyway. Samsung should stop to advertise the Galaxy Z Flip as having a foldable glass screen, since people will always think of glass as glass. Anyway, it is the first ever fold device with a glass screen, which is very fragile, but it's the best.